Just don't need such arguments.
Let's do the Dalai Lama thing. It is final.
Ma'am, shouldn't we be afraid? They are 50 years ahead of us.
Evolution is not everything. And we are also on the verge of full reconstruction.
So basically, you are trying to say that we can prevent them from attacking us by doing things which will provoke them into attacking us?
Ma'am, I will tell you when and where to reach. You just need to enhance the Bureau of Reconstruction.
Oh, you guys seem to be confused. But let me clear your confusion first. It's a story couple of decades from now. India is not shining. The Chinese, they have nuked large parts of our country. Bombay has been completely wiped out. And Delhi is on the verge of a rigorous reconstruction. And Bengal, it has become a protectorate of these bloody Chinese. And whatever remains, that has been taken over by the Maoists. Now the most powerful person is the competent authority. As you have just seen, he's the head of the Bureau of Reconstruction and rules the remnants of India with an iron fist. Although we have the PM, the CBI director, the armed forces, but they are just mere puppets. All they do is watch in horror as the competent authority tries to put his flendish plan into motion, that is to annihilate everyone in the country. Now only one person can save him, and that is a 12-year-old mutant from Shantinagar, Pinto. Shantinagar is a place where usually poor people live, and in order to save our country, Pinto has appointed three reluctant henchmen. The first one is a pessimistic but a determined individual, CBI officer Mr. Chatterjee.
The sky seems to be blue. Clouds are pure and seems like 15 years back in Tokyo when the Indians were allowed to travel. And wait a minute, which building is that?
Oh, Mr. Chatterjee. Mr. Chatterjee has just recognized that he was sent back in time by Pinto with a piece of paper that had a note.
Save Mahatma Gandhi?
Save Mahatma Gandhi. And so he started asking for the nearby police stations. Here, let me help him out. Sir! Sir! Very good house, sir. Very good house and going cheap. 5 bedrooms. British style. Luxury bungalow. And sir, price include cook, mali and driver also, sir. And sir, only 2 of such houses are left, sir. And sir, this one, it is kept for a special fan. Sir, why do these government babus get all the good houses? You also deserve a good one, sir.
But how do you know I can afford a good house near India Gate?
Arre, sir, you are wearing English type clothes. Anyone can see you are a big man, sir. And sir, moreover, you are asking for the police station. Sir, no small man asked for the police station, sir. No good comes out of visiting there. And you, sir, you are smiling sweetly and asking which way to the police station, as if it is a horticulture garden. Really, sir, you are a big man, sir.
Well, thank you for your proposal, but actually, I need to go to the police station. It's urgent. Please tell me the way to go.
Please follow me.
Thank you.
It's that way.
Oh, thank you.
What service can I provide you, Lordship?
Actually, I have gotten news about Gandhi.
Ah, Gandhi!
Yeah.
Bapu!
Yeah, Bapu. Actually, he is going to die soon.
Die?
Yeah.
Bapu is an old man, sir. Everybody must die. You, me, everybody must die eventually, sir.
No. Actually, he is going to die.
Die!
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 Kill!
Oh, kill!
Yes!
Yes, sir!
By 3 persons. I remember. Yeah, first one is Godse and other 2 are from RSS. I don't remember their names. Oh, my headache.
Oh, sir, that's natural. Losing your memory when hit on the head. Let me try it again, sir. I will hit you with the same stick. You might recover your memory, sir.
No. Actually, it's a conspiracy. Why don't
conspiracy?
You understand? Yes. Okay. They are going to kill him.
Okay.
Yes. Yes, I remember.
Yes.
One is Godse.
Godse.
Other one is Sarvarkar.
Yes. Sir, let me write, sir.
Yeah, sure, please.
Sir, paper.
I don't have any paper.
Sir, answer.
Yeah, yeah, please, answer. Yeah. One is Godse.
Godse?
Yes. Other one, Sarvarkar.
Sarvarkar?
Other one from RSS. I don't RSS. Remember his name, yeah. And yes, yes, they are going to kill him with a pistol.
Pistol?
Yes.
Okay, sir.
And his last words would be, Hey Ram.
Hey Ram. Hey Ram. Yes, sir.
And these three guys are from Maharashtra.
Maharashtra?
Yes.
So they are all Maharashtrians?
Yes.
And pistol?
Yes.
And Hey Ram.
Hey Ram.
Ram means devotee of Ram,
yes,
sir.
Yes, yes, yes.
Sir, don't worry. I will raise them in 2 hours.
2 hours?
Yes, sir. 2 hours.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir. 2 hours.
2 hours?
Yes, sir.
Okay. 2 hours.
2 hours, sir.
2 hours. 2 hours.
Jai Hind.
Oh, Jai Hind.
Poor guy. Memory loss. On the other hand, Pinto have appointed the second member. That is the last surviving member of Al-Qaeda. Ali. Ali is tasting the sweet water which is being sprinkled on his face.
Poor man. He must have worked all day and starved from hunger. Bro, Ramzan fasting is hard for these laborers.
Perhaps he has not eaten for a long time due to these high prices. This war has been long over. But still, those banyas are making money.
Are you guys from Chittagong? Am I in Chittagong?
Arre, he has been hit hard on his head. Let's take him to the doctor.
We are in Calcutta. We speak in Chittagong style because we lived there. Our father brought us here when Japanese bombarded Chittagong.
We thought you were a laborer, but you don't seem like one. And why do you have this picture of Mahishasura on your chest?
That's Bob Marley, a band singer from Murshidabad. And wait a minute. You just said about Japanese bombs, but those were Chinese.
Ayayo, either you're very smart or very stupid.
He's cute and handsome.
You shut up and you listen. I don't know what Chinese are you talking about, but they were the Japanese who attacked India and were defeated by the Britishers. Since Netaji helped them too, he's hiding in the Himalayas. But he will be back when everything is okay. But these are big things. We are small. I just know that the war has been over for a long time. And the prices, they are going up by 3 times. But still those rascal banyas are making money.
The most powerful person is the competent authority. He's the head of the Bureau of Reconstruction and rules the remnants of India with an iron fist. The competent authority, Sahil. Sonia Gandhi, Neeti Gupta. And the CBI director, Abhishek Sood. And the director of a place is Sudesh Sharma. And on music, we have Karan Singh Bisht. And as Manmohan Singh and the inspector, Bhavshil Singh Sahani.
11 years writing the competent authority, which taught him a very important lesson. When writing about the near future, it's better to write a little faster. He was born in the UK, but brought back to India. This makes him a reverse immigrant. And he was just the first of the many instances in which he traveled in the wrong direction. We request Ms. Dipanjana Pal and Mr. Shobhan Chaudhary to kindly come on the podium for the discussion on the book, The Competent Authority.
In this lovely dramatization, thank you again.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
This was great fun, but I just thought that you should have some idea of the scope of the competent authority's powers, because he is a great, great man. And accountants should be happy that he abbreviates to CA. Anyone who has to go to accountants will not be happy, but that's a separate matter. So the compared to the CA, all of us are nothing. The CA has the power to demolish houses and convert them into latrines. The CA knows the number of everyone's Swiss bank account. The CA can eradicate illiteracy with the flick of a pen. The CA can collect in advance and refund at leisure. The CA can bestow petrol pump licenses and cooking gas connections, and also he can take away, which is not food, by the way, the licenses. The CA commands the power of invisibility. He can build invisible hospitals and fill them with invisible doctors. He can make vast quantities of minerals travel invisibly across the land. He can create miles and miles of irrigation that no one will ever see. The CA can redraw the borders of states just because their shapes displease him. The CA can prevent dengue by declaring Section 144. The CA can command Air India to fly him wherever he wants. Nothing is beyond the scope, purview, or grasp of the almighty, all-seeing, all-knowing CA. So let's begin at the beginning, which is, where does the CA come from?
Yeah, you know what happens is there are a lot of government circulars, and almost any government circular or notice that you see, somewhere in it, it's got by authority of the, or as per the instructions of the competent authority. All of them, practically any document. So I started thinking, supposing it's actually a guy, you know, like we just don't know about him, but there's this guy called the competent authority who's, you know, it explains a lot. You know, and if he's insane, then it explains even more, you know. And the thing is that in the IAS, as far as I've understood, insanity is not grounds for dismissal. I mean, nothing is grounds for dismissal.
It might actually be a ground for qualification.
It might be. I mean, they haven't reached that stage, but it's not grounds for dismissal. So it's inevitable that at some point a lunatic is going to be in charge, right? I mean, you know, because they're
telling me about Section 144.
I mean, I just want to tell you, for example, the district magistrate of Thiruvananthapuram last year, because he was faced with a dengue outbreak, he declared Section 144 throughout the town for 30 days. You know, and the thing is that dengue is usually spread through, you know, spit and urine. So one can only conclude that everybody in Thiruvananthapuram sort of spits and pees on each other all the time, which is why he had them locked up for 30 days. Now, that man could be running the coal ministry tomorrow, or God forbid, the defense ministry. So, you know, it's like that.
So you've been writing this for 11 years.
Yeah.
Right from the, so in the book there are sort of two stories that are running almost parallelly, and they come together at the end. One is Pintu's story of changing history, and one is the CA's story about taking over the country one invisible step at a time. Were they always two separate stories, or were they always one story?
They were kind of connected. I mean, it's like two ends of the spectrum, no? I mean, one is my bap and the other is, you know, one of the bachas. So I guess they were always connected. I mean, to some extent, the time travel thing and people going back versus the whole story about, you know, the CA being in Delhi and sort of looming large. They could be separate, but I don't know. They were pretty much connected from the beginning, honestly.
And these three agents of change that you pick, Hemanto, Pandeji, whom I love. I think Pandeji might actually be my favorite. Not only because he's the only one who actually succeeds in his mission. Tell us a little about Pandeji.
Pandeji is Delhi police. He's with you and for you always. And depending on how much money you can give him, he'll be with you longer. So in the future, there's a rate card, you know, so things are much clearer. And, you know, transactions are much more sort of, you know, positive in that sense. So that's Pandey, really. I mean, he's...
And when we meet him for the first time, he's been hired.
Yeah, he started out as a villain, you know. But as you started thinking about him, I realized that, you know, I mean, the fact is that the police here have, like, no weapons, man. I mean, they have, like, pistols which date back to, you know, World War I or something. And, I mean, you're more likely to blow yourself up than actually kill someone if you fire one of those weapons. Whereas everybody from, you know, Dawood Ibrahim's nephew to, you name it, they've all got AK-47s. And so I think, I mean, the police, I found myself finding a lot of sympathy for the police eventually.
But the police have the power of sub judice.
The police have the power of everything. The police have the power of everything. They can do... See, the Indian Penal Code of 1861, it was put together just after 1857. This is not a coincidence. The objective of that thing was ki natives ko dawa ke rakhna hai. So far it's been working.
Very well.
Yeah.
Very well. So Pandey ji, like we said, is my favorite. We also meet him very dramatically. The first time we meet him, he's being hired to kill a dog. And a dog, the dog being the dog on the cover, that is actually an Alsatian in the future, in case you were wondering.
He objected.
He objected. I won't make you talk about the Bengali man just yet. Let's talk about the last surviving member of Al-Qaeda.
Yeah.
Why Al-Qaeda? Why not the Maoists? Why is not the Maoist your, you know, extremist element in the book?
That's a good question, actually. One is I didn't know enough about the Maoists. I haven't done enough research, so I didn't have much of a clue. And the second is that I read a book about Al-Qaeda, and I discovered that they're amazingly corporate. They send emails and memos to each other about leave travel allowance, and they make PowerPoint presentations, and I thought the world needed to know this, you know, so that's really why. I can't think, they're just insanely funny, so I thought they should be in the book.
They are, and this is the really fun thing about Competent Authority, that you have truly depressing things that make you laugh. How hard is it to take what is actually not funny at all and make it funny?
I don't know. I think that, see, the thing is that what happens in our country is that the news is horrifying, right? We watch the news for half an hour and there are like six disasters one after the other, you know? And I think the natural inclination of people is, bhai, dekhna hi nahi hai. You know, it's a bit like if you're on your honeymoon, right, and you're in the hotel room and the television is on and, you know, the Miss World competition is going on and you're the husband, obviously. You don't look at it too closely at that time. You know, you might glance at it from time to time from the side of your eye, but you're not going to sit there sort of staring at it because, I mean, that's just not a good idea, right?
It's not polite.
It's a bad idea, yeah. And
also potentially murderous situation.
It depends on the lady, of course. But the thing is, you sort of glance at it, but you don't look too closely. And I think that's our relation to the news now. The news is so horrible most of the time that you don't want to get into the details because it's too, I mean, my wife gets up and leaves half the time when the news is like, yeah, dekhna nahi hai. I said, very good, you know, don't, what can you do? But my point is that, you know, if you make it a little funny, then you're more likely to sort of look at it, you know, look at that event. And the thing is, when you look at things now, then you notice details. You know, then you notice, I mean, people will eventually notice how well you're dressed, for example, you know, because once you look closely and all that, right?